Hello, nurses. Are you ready for another medical surgical discussion for today? Well, I am serving you another medical surgical topic in nursing because for today, we're gonna have pyloneal cyst. If you wanna know more about that, stay tuned. Welcome back, nurses, to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Neil Gavin. I'm a registered nurse and I do have a degree in medical surgical nursing. I create nursing educational content to help nursing students and nursing professionals in reviewing the concept of nursing. If you are interested in that, consider subscribing. If you're already a subscriber though, thank you so much for your love and support. I see you. I upload my nursing educational videos 2 to 3 times in a week. Don't miss that out. Subscribe now. Hit that notification bell so that you will be the very first to watch my newest uploads. Also, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and share with your friends because that will really help them know they like to see more contents like this. Without further ado, let's jump into the video. Good morning, nurses. For today, we are going to have another medical surgical topic because on this video, I'm going to teach you the concept of pyloneal cyst. Yes, if you haven't heard about pyloneal cyst or if you're that nurse who's handling a patient who is diagnosed with pyloneal cyst, baby, this video is right for you. I will give you everything that you need to know, definition of terms, diagnostic, assessment, and also nursing responsibilities. In order for me to do that, I will need to switch back to my PC and I'll see you guys in a bit. Hi everybody, welcome sa ating formal discussion ng yung pyloneal cyst nursing care management. This is another nursing study guide under sa medical surgical nursing where I give you some tips and lectures about med-surg. Now, kung hindi ka pa familiar sa concept ng yung pyloneal cyst o hindi ka pa nakaka-encounter ng case na to sa ER o sa area mo, huwag ka mag-alala kasi this video is right for you. Alright, let's begin our discussion with our objectives for today. We're gonna have description, the cause, the signs and symptoms, how are you gonna diagnose pyloneal cyst, the medical treatment, and of course, your nursing responsibilities. You ready? Let's do this. Alright, first up, description. So, pyloneal cyst or pyloneal or nest of hair is common condition in the midline buttock cleft skin. Some experts think it is present from birth, but it is more likely an acquired condition. Although the exact cause is not clear, a pyloneal cyst almost always involves hair trapped in red swollen cyst or ating closed sac beneath the skin for long periods of time. It is usually near the small indentations in the midline buttock cleft skin. So, nandito siya, you guys. So, ito siya. Oh. Ayan. So, di siya kadalasan makikita. Because it is a cyst that may be different depending on the person, it is not a simple cyst. We use the term pyloneal disease. It affects men and women equally and usually occurs in younger persons ages 15 to 35. Now, there's a type of cyst you can get at the bottom of your tailbone. Ito nga po siya sa ating coccyx. It's called pyloneal cyst. Itong ating dinidiscuss ngayon. Now, this can become infected and filled with pus. Once infected, the technical term is pyloneal abscess and it can be painful. It looks like a large pimple at the bottom of your tailbone. It is more common in men than in women. It usually happens more often in younger people. Hence, ang ating age group 15 to 35. So, ano-ano yung mga group of people natin na kadalasan naapekto ng yung pyloneal cyst? Sila yung mga taong madalas umuupo, yung matagalang pag-upo. Halimbawa, yung truck drivers. Now, these people have higher chance of getting one. They can be treated, yes. If your cyst becomes a problem, your doctor can drain it or take it out through surgery. Now, let's discuss more. What are the causes of your pyloneal cyst? Risk factors for pyloneal cyst include family history, sedentary job, extensive body hair, smoking, and obesity. It is more common among younger adults, with men affected 3 to 4 times more often than women. Friction from clothing, tight clothing, or sitting for prolonged periods may also cause the area to become inflamed. Now, spending a long time sitting and friction that occurs frequently in the area of the buttocks may cause hair or sometimes dirt hard at the cleft of your buttocks to end up embedded in the skin. Your body forms a cavity around it, thinking that it is an invader and can leave you with a health problem. The said cavity may be attacked by bacteria, ending up infected. So these are the causes or risk factors for your pyelonephritis. Alright, so what are the signs and symptoms? Ito na po siya, you guys. Pain in the skin between the buttocks. Pain and or swelling to one side of the groove at the top of the buttocks. Bleeding and or drainage form an area of inflammation near the groove at the top of the buttocks. So, most common nga po siya dito sa ating buttocks area. How are you going to diagnose this? Well, doctors diagnose a pyelonephritis by first doing a physical examination. Ang pinaka diagnosis ng iyong pyelonephritis. So anong gusto ko maalala mo? Kapag nakakita ka ng lumps, swelled or abscess at the cleft of the buttock with tenderness and possibly a draining or bleeding doon sa area na yon, you can actually suspect pyelonephritis, okay? Now, medical treatment. Treatment always involves surgical removal of the cyst. Treatment must also include removal of hair from the surrounding skin. This needs to be done while the wound is healing and for up to a year afterwards. The single most important measure to prevent recurrency of pyelonephritis disease is shaving or removal of hair from the buttock cleft area and keeping it free of hair for 6 to 12 months after the wound is healed. Now, here are some options that the doctor can do to your patients. Alright, so treatments, again, gusto ko lang maalala mo at emphasize na antibiotics do not heal pyelonephritis cyst. Yes, but doctors have any number of procedures they can try. Ano-ano yung mga procedures na yun? Normally, outpatient surgery ito. Handa ka na, ito na siya. Well, una, pwedeng gawin ng doktor mo is yung tinatawag nating incision and drainage. Now, this is the preferred method for a first pyelonephritis cyst. Your doctor makes a cut into the cyst and drains it. He removes any hair follicles and leaves the wound open, packing the space with gauze. Now, ano yung advantage nito? It's a simple procedure done under local anesthesia, meaning just the area around the cyst is numbed. Not general, ito itsura niya. Local anest na to, hence, kaya siya ginagawa sa outpatient surgery. Pagkatapos ng surgery, pwede na umuwi ang pasyente, bumalik na lang for wound dressing. Ano pa? Disadvantage. Isa nga sa mga disadvantage ng iyong incision and drainage o yung IND is you have to change the gauze often until the cyst heals, which sometimes takes up to 3 weeks. Okay. Meron tayong ginagawang special type of packing para sa iyong pyelonephritis post-IND. So, mamaya tatalakay natin yun. Alright. What are the other surgical treatments that you can do? Marsupialization. Now, in this procedure, your doctor makes a cut and drains the cyst, removing pus and any hair that are inside. Now, your doctor will sew the edges of the cut to the wound edges to make a pouch. Now, anong advantage nito? This is an outpatient surgery under local anesthesia, same as your IND. It also lets the doctor make a smaller or shallower cut so that you don't need or the patient don't need to take out and repack gauze daily. Ang disadvantage, it takes 6 weeks to heal and you need a doctor specially trained in the technique. Ano pa? Pinakalas mong option, you have your incision drainage closing of wound kung saan iko-close na talaga siya. In this technique, the cyst is drained but it is not left open unlike your IND. Alright? Now, anong advantage nito? You don't need to pack gauze because your doctor fully closes the wound right after surgery. Anong disadvantage? The patient more likely to have more problems with the cyst down the road. It's harder to remove the entire cyst with this method. It's usually done in an operating room with a special trained surgeon. Other surgical procedures include complete cyst and cyst wall excision along with a pyelonephritis sinus tract, the use of fibrin glue and taking only diseased tissue and cyst out with pouch biopsies. Once again, these are your medical management for your pyelonephritis doses. Again, walang antibiotic, kundi outpatient surgery, IND. Okay, so what are the nursing responsibilities? Nurses, listen. Initially, treatment of the pyelonidosis involves incision and drainage of the area. Oral antibiotics are not usually required given that the infection is localized. Now, after the area has been incised, wound care involves daily irrigation with sterile water or wound cleanser in a syringe and packing of the wound because the wound will need to heal from the base up. Meaning, hindi yung skin muna pababa, base up. Naalala mo na may na iniiwan siyang parang uka. Yun siya. So, kailangan mag-heal siya pababa, pataas, mula sa baba, pataas. Now, as the wound begins to heal, less packing will be required. It is important to fill the wound and to not pack tightly because this can impede healing. So, minimal packing nga po, not too tight, kasi it can impede wound healing. Isa pa sa gusto kong maalala mo, hindi po tayo gumagamit ng, well, first few days, pwede kang gumamit ng betadine, pero as you go along the wound dressing, as the patient is healing, or the wound is healing, putting betadine is not really necessary. Normal saline lang po ang ating ginagamit sa pag-wound dressing, okay? Now, the greatest impact on healing is offloading. Make sure the patient understands that he or she needs to keep pressure off the area while it is healing, as well as avoiding shear and friction. Now, the patient should avoid prolonged sitting and tight clothing. Moisture management is also very important and can be achieved with absorptive dressing unless the patient has a large amount of drainage, which may require negative pressure. You guys, very important po na we keep the area dry and free from moisture. Why? Because once you have that moisture there, once it's wet, it's soaked, you can actually invite bacteria and that could promote infection. You don't want that, okay? No tub baths should be taken while the wound is healing or acutely inflamed. You guys, these are your nursing responsibilities in dealing with patients who's diagnosed with pyelonidocyst. Mapapansin mo more on ano tayo, wound dressing, wound management, okay? So, importante na you use normal saline in cleaning the patient's wound. Ano pa, hindi ka dapat gumamit ng betadine because it can make the wound fresh, it can impede the wound healing process, and lalagyan mo siya na isusok mo lang yung gauze sa kanyang tag dito sa PNSS and then ipapalaman mo siya doon sa loob. But not too much, not too tight. You want it just enough amount of gauze to clean the area and to put packing inside, alright? So, yun na siya. Once again, you guys, thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel for more nursing educational videos. Let me know if you have other nursing topics that you want us to do. Comment it down below. Abangan nyo po yung mga susunod nating videos ha, regarding sa ating nursing subjects. Alright? Now, I really want to grab this opportunity to thank everybody, especially you who's watching right now for making this happen. Maraming salamat po. Ma-appreciate ko kung i-share mo to sa mga friends mo para mas marami pang makaalam. You guys, we've been really, really growing and that is all because of you. I'll see you again next time. You guys stay safe.
Thank you so much, you guys, for watching. I hope you learned something. Help me grow my channel.
You are already here. You might as well subscribe #TeamCoolTalk.
Give this video a big thumbs up and share with your friends. Let me know what you guys think. You put them down in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to check out the other playlists I created for you. We'll be putting the links on the description box or simply click this icon button right here. Let's connect. Follow me on all my other social media accounts. Everything is at Neil Gabe. I'll see you again.